For drawing cycloid, the data required is diameter of the rolling circle. Now, I'll assume the diameter of the rolling circle as 50 mm. And with 50 mm diameter, first draw the circle as shown here. Diameter of this circle is 50 mm. This is the first step. Then divide this circle into four equal parts by drawing horizontal and vertical lines. Next, my aim is to divide this circle into 12 equal parts. To divide this circle into 12 equal parts, first draw a 30 degree line from the center C and extend this on the bottom side also, as shown. Next, draw a 60 degree line and extend this on the bottom side, as shown. Repeat the same procedure on the other side. On this side also, you can repeat the same procedure like this. Now this circle is divided into 12 parts. Next step is, at the 12th division, somewhere here, draw a tangent to this circle, and this length of this tangent, this line, is 2 pi r. With 2 pi r length, you have to draw a tangent at the bottom point, somewhere here. Next, divide this line also into same number of equal parts which you have considered on this circle. Here, circle is divided into 12 parts. So, divide this line also into 12 parts, like this. So, for dividing this line into 12 equal parts, you can follow the inclined line method. Draw an inclined line, and along that inclined line, take 12 parts. Then, following the method, you can get the 12 equal divisions here on this line. The next step is, draw the locus lines at 3, 6 and complete a rectangle like this. Next, draw a locus line from 7 and 5. This is the locus line of 7 and 5. Next, draw a locus line joining 8 and 4 like this. Next, draw another locus line joining 10 and 2. Already we have drawn the locus line from 9 and 3. Now you draw the locus line joining 10 and 2. And draw another locus line joining 11 and 1. Okay. After drawing these locus lines, now you have to draw the locus of centers. So when this point 1 is coinciding with the point 1 on this line, then this center C is shifted to somewhere here. That point we will call as a C1, and to get C1 point, draw a projector from point 1 on the straight line, and this point we will call as a C1. Similarly, to get C2, draw a projector from 2, and this is C2. Similarly, for C3, you can repeat the same procedure. Remaining points you can obtain by following the same procedure. C4, C5, C6, C7, C8, C9, C10, C11, C12. Okay. After getting the locus of centers, the next step is, we have to trace the points on the cycloid. For that, take C1 as center. Take C1, this point as center, with R radius, that means radius of the rolling circle. Here radius of the rolling circle is 25. Diameter is 50, hence radius is 25. Take radius of the rolling circle as radius. Draw an arc onto locus of 1. This is locus of 1. C1 as center with 25 radius, draw an arc onto locus of 1. the torque you are getting somewhere here. This is the torque. This is the radius. This radius is 25, which is the radius of the rolling circle. This point we will call as P1. This point is P1. Next, to get P2, take C2 as center with same 25 radius, that is radius of the rolling circle. Draw an arc onto locus of 2. Here you have to draw the arc like this. This is the arc. This point is, this is the radius. 25 is the radius now. This point is P2. This is P2. Next, to get P3, take C3 as center. Here we are changing only centers. Radius is same. C3 center with same 25 radius. Draw an arc onto locus of 3. Here you are getting the arc. And this point is P3. Next, for getting P4, take C4 as center. With same rolling circle radius 25, draw an arc onto locus of 4. This is the radius 25. Then this point is P4. Next, for P5, repeat the same procedure. C5 center with 25 radius. Draw the arc onto locus of 5. This radius is again same 25. This is P5. For P6, take C6 center with same 25 radius. Draw the arc. This is P6. For P7, C7 center, repeat the same procedure. Here you will get P7. For P8, for P9, you can repeat the same procedure. This is center for P10. This is the arc. Here you will get P10. Next, C11 as center with same 25 radius, draw the arc. Here you will get P11. This is C12. Here you will get P12. If you take C12 as center, automatically you are getting the P12 somewhere here only. That means 12 point is coinciding with the P12 point. 12 point is coinciding with the P12 point. Now joining P1, P2, P3, so on P12, you draw a smooth curve like this. This is the required cycloid. Next, we will see how to draw a tangent and normal. For drawing tangent and normal, I will take a random point in between P7 and P8 like this. At this point, I want tangent and normal. Now, what I can do is, for getting tangent and normal, take given point P as center with same 25 radius, draw an arc onto locus of centers. Something like this, you will get the arc. This is the arc. Now, draw a line from P to this intersection point, and from there you drop a projector like this. Drop a projector. This projector is intersecting with the directing line. This point we can call as M. This is M. Line joining this M and P gives the normal. This is the normal. Perpendicular to this normal, if you draw a line from point P, that will be the tangent. This is the tangent. This is the procedure for drawing cycloid and drawing tangent and normal to the cycloid at any point.